We took ground, bit at a time, and of course we took some casualties. I was a medic, so I encountered some of my first wounded folks, and it was difficult because as a young fellow, you really don't expect what you eventually see. And one of our experiences early on was we came across a group of American soldiers who had camped, and they'd only posted the minimum sentries, and they were about 40 of them all killed in their sleeping bags. So as a Canadian soldier, we discarded our sleeping bags and used blankets from then on. Well, I realized that war wasn't pretty by that stage. And as a medic, it was a shock to see a casualty. My first one was an accident. A soldier tried to get into a half-track vehicle with his weapon pointing towards him, and it discharged, hitting him in the chest. And I looked, it hit him on the right side, so I rolled him over so I could see his right back. There was nothing there. In the meantime, a doctor was standing there and said, "S, turn him over to the other side." I turned him over to the other side, and the exit wound was way down low on his left side, and that really shocked me.
Medic.
Oh, we were really close. We had to go right to the front lines to evacuate. Like, infantry unit had its own stretcher bearers and its own medics, but we had to go right to that point to receive them and take them back to a casualty clearing post. There's a regimental assist post, usually a dugout or a tent or whatever, depending on the terrain, and that's where they get immediate assistance. We pick them up with a Jeep ambulance and transport them back to what's called a casualty clearing post, and it's fundamentally first aid at that stage. And the hard part, again, as a young fellow, was to imagine that you would treat the least injured quicker than those that were severely injured. That was hard to understand. But those that were least seriously wounded were able to get back into action, so the focus was there. Huh?